am Saraswati, CRT Maths, KGBV, Middutty. Today our topic inverse proportion. You will be able to understand first one when are two quantities said to be in proportion. Second one, conditions for two quantities to be in inverse proportion. Third one, to find out the missing quantity when two quantities are in inverse proportion. Fourth one, application of inverse proportion in our day-to-day life. Look at the situation. Here we see a girl using different ways of going to school. If she walks at a speed of 3 km per hour, she reaches a school in 30 minutes. Now, if she goes to school by running at the speed of 6 km per hour, she reaches a school in 15 minutes. If she goes to school by cycling at a speed of 9 km per hour, she reaches a school in 10 minutes. If she goes to school by a car at speed of 45 km per hour, she reaches a school in 2 minutes. In the situation, when she walks at 3 km per hour, she reaches a school in 30 minutes. If she runs at 6 km per hour, she reaches a school in 15 minutes. If she uses her cycle and goes at a speed of 9 km per hour, she reaches her school in 10 minutes. When she goes in a car at speed of 45 km per hour, she reaches a school in 2 minutes. So, we see that when increased her speed 2 times the normal speed, the time taken decreases by half time. If speed is increased by 3 times, and time taken decreases by 1 by 3rd. And if speed is increased 15 times, then the time taken is decreased by 1 by 15. Or we can also say that high speed increases and time decreases in same ratio. Now we see that speed into time is same in all conditions. So speed into time is constant. Speed into time is equal to constant. So another example. Look at this another activity. 6 marbles can be arranged in 1 row and 6 column. Now let the same 6 marbles can be arranged in 2 rows and 3 columns. Otherwise 6 marbles can be arranged in 3 rows and 2 columns. Now 6 marbles arranged in 6 rows and 1 column. Now let us frame a table for the arrangement of marbles. What do you observe? As the number of rows are increases, the number of columns are decreases. We see that R into C is constant in all the above situations. We saw that as one quantity increases, other quantity decreases. Such variation. What in increase in one quantity resulting in a decrease in the other quantity is said to be inverse proportion. So, two quantities X and Y are said to be in inverse proportion. X into Y is constant, that is XY equal to K. Okay?